Hi, I'm Sally Bain, an associate professor in the School of Aeronautics and Astronautics, and I also have a courtesy appointment in the School of Mechanical Engineering. We are here in one of my laboratories. I call this laboratory the Plasma Aerodynamics and Combustion Science Lab, CAPS for short. This lab is located at Purdue's Aerospace Sciences Laboratory, which is located near the Purdue Airport and our Aviation Technology School. So my research areas, I have pretty broad research interests, but they really are focused in three major areas. The first is experimental combustion dynamics, where we look at the fundamentals of how fuels burn, of flame propagation, transition to detonation. The second area is plasmas for aerospace applications. I focus on what we call ultra-short pulsed plasmas or non-equilibrium plasmas. And the applications I'm particularly interested in is using them for combustion control and for aerodynamic flow control. The third area is general plasma and flow diagnostics, looking at new and state-of-the-art ways to measure the characteristics of plasmas, as well as fluid flows and combustion flows. So this is one of the smaller scale combustion experiments that we have in this lab. You'll see behind it on the wall a couple pictures of very large explosions. So at Zucro Labs, I have a 20-foot combustion tube that's about a foot in diameter. So that's a very nice, impressive experiment, but if we want to understand what's going on inside of the tube, like how when we ignite the fuel mixture, how the flame accelerates and transitions into a detonation, we need to have smaller scale, more fundamental experiments. And so this is one of those experiments. This is a detonation tube, a flame acceleration and detonation tube. And you'll see that it's like a small version of our 20-foot tube, but in this case, we have windows all along both sides. And so we're able to actually watch the combustion wave as it propagates down the tube and analyze what is causing it to accelerate and in some cases transition to a supersonic detonation wave. So my second area of research is on using plasmas for aerospace applications. And as I mentioned, I'm particularly interested in two applications, one being control of combustion and the second being aerodynamic flow control. So I'll show you a couple experiments we have here that are looking at those two applications. So the first experiment here is looking at plasma control of combustion. So this is a burner, and we have a mixture of fuel and air that comes in and up through the burner tube. Inside of the burner, we have a swirler, which generates rotation in the flow, and then we then can put a match or a spark in there and light up a flame. And this flame is what we call a swirl stabilized flame, and it's a small scale version of the kind of combustion that you would see in a typical gas turbine engine on an aircraft. So once we have the flame established here, we can first study things about the flame itself, such as the stability of the flame using pressure signals. So here we actually have a couple microphones for detecting pressure fluctuations due to the combustion. We also have it confined inside a glass chamber so that we have optical access to visualize the flame and to do other measurements such as particle image velocimetry, which we actually have set up right now, and I'll talk about in a moment, or other laser-based spectroscopic diagnostics. Now, in addition to studying just the dynamics of such a flame, as I said, we're interested in affecting those dynamics using plasmas. So it's a little hard to see, but you can see that there's this metal rod sticking out here, and there's another one on the other side. These are electrodes, and they extend inwards and have two sharpened tips at either end of the, at the exit of the burner tube. And what we do is we connect these electrodes to a high voltage pulse generator, and we can then generate plasma in the gap between the two electrodes. We then, using the diagnostics we talked about, we can look at how generating these plasmas can force the flow and affect the chemical reactions in the combustion. So the second application I mentioned, in addition to what we call plasma-assisted combustion, is aerodynamic flow control using plasmas. So this is an area that's been around for about 20 years now, where people have been looking into generating plasmas on the surfaces of aerodynamic bodies, for example, on the surface of an airfoil or a wing, and using the effects of the plasma on the flow to improve performance of the wing, such as reducing the drag. So I also work in this area. I am more interested in using plasmas to control high-speed flows, specifically supersonic and hypersonic flows. Here on the table, we have a couple examples of some plasma actuators that we're developing. If we're interested in aerodynamic flow control, we want to be able to generate the plasma on the surface of an aerodynamic body. So we build actuators that look kind of like this, where we have electrodes actually glued or attached onto the surface. So this is a desktop model where we again apply the high voltage and we generate plasma filaments between these sawteeth. This is the supersonic wind tunnel here at the Aerospace Sciences Laboratory. And this is the wind tunnel I use to test my plasma actuators. So I showed this before. This is a surface actuator which generates plasma filaments. And what we do is we attach this to a fixture which slides inside the tunnel and sits flush with the surface. And we run the flow anywhere from Mach 0.6 up to Mach 3.5, depending on what nozzle we have installed. And we can operate the actuator and use visualization and the existing Schlieren visualization to study the effect of the plasma on the supersonic flow field. So I've mentioned with all these experiments, the various flow diagnostics we do. And that's really my third area of focus, is improving the accuracy and utility of high-speed flow diagnostics. So in this lab, we can do three different flow measurements simultaneously. The first is basic Schlieren visualization, which is this light source and these optics here. The second measurement that we can do is measuring the flow velocity, and we do that using particle image velocimetry, or PIV. Here we have a 10 kilohertz PIV laser with the associated optics, and it allows us to record velocity vectors at a rate up to 20 kilohertz. Right now you can see the PIV system is set up for recording particle image velocimetry of the flow, the swirled flow out of the burner. But we also use this to measure the flow in various combustion experiments, as well as the flow induced in our plasma discharges. The third diagnostic allows us to measure the flow density, and that measurement technique is called background-oriented Schlieren. And it's a very simple measurement technique, where here we have a dot pattern which we place behind our field of view of interest. And by looking at the apparent distortion of the dots, when you visualize them through the density gradient field, we can actually extract the density of the flow. So the result is, for a given experiment, we can simultaneously see the flow using the Schlieren visualization and measure the velocity and density using the PIV and background-oriented Schlieren.